So in class, sometimes we also set up these korvais. So if there's a kirtanam, we kind of figure out, okay, what kind of korvai can we do? What kind of math can we do? What sounds aesthetic? And each one has a different approach to it. Some people do it with the mathematics involved. There's 72, there's 128. How do I divide it? What do I do? I kind of do it slightly differently. For me, it's I just start a form, some kind of a formation, and then use that formation to see how it can mathematically work. That's how it works for me. These guys also work differently. They work with math also, right? So suppose you're going to make a korvai. Shall we try it? Enda edo enda ragam. Anything. Adi thala mbichikla. Mishra cha bichikla. Change it. Or no, we'll take a bigger thala. We'll take mishra jampa. Okay? பாடின கூட பண்ண முடியாது என்ன சௌமித்ரியா சௌமித்ரி தியாக சௌமித்ரி தியாக எக்ஸ்பிளைன் டு தம் ஹவ் யூ வில் மேக் எ கோர்வை
So this thalam is 10 beats totally, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And each beat is 4.
In male column.
In male column where we normally formulate a korvai. So one entire avartanam will be 10 into 4, 40. And the edupu of this place
or
is...
Or the beginning. It's sum.
Is 2 after beat. In, again, the... male column or the higher speed.
When he's saying 4 per beat, it's that could 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Keep the mic next to you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how it's 40. And then when he says 2, it's 1, 2, Saumitri.
So basically the idea for this, I mean for the korvais that we sing is the same as the one for the mridangam that he explained before. It has to be sung 3 times. So... There can kind of be an idea that moves across the 3 times but has a progression to it, or it can be the same thing across 3 times. And at the end, when you finish the third cycle, it has to start at the place where we have been singing swarams. So how I would calculate this is, I mean, it has to be first divisible by 3, which means, because if we have to do it 3 times. So the way I would look at it is, if one cycle is 40, then 3 cycles is 120. Which is straight away divisible by 3. So which means I need to create a korvai or a math for 40. For 40. And if I sing it thrice from where the song starts, the third time when I finish the cycle, it will be there in place.
So make one. Moon round or no? சமத்துல எடுத்துடா நீ ஓகே சொல்லு பாடு சரி கொஞ்சம் சுரம் பாடி இந்த எடுத்து தனி சிறி சிறி சரி காரி சனிதா
gari dani dari gari dani dari ri dani da ba ma ba da ba dani da ba dani dari dani da ni dani dani dari da gari ri dani gari sa ni da ba gari sa gari dani dani ri dani da ba da
sa ni da ma ma ga ma ba ma pa da pa da ni ga ma ba da ba da
ma ba dani dani
ba dani sa ni gari sa ni da ba gari sa gari dani dani ri dani da ba da sa ni da ba ma sa u mi
very simple. The math, the arithmetic is simple. Garisa is 3. Garisa is 3. Add one gap for each. Then it becomes 6. Then add 2 gaps. Becomes 9. So 3, 6, 9 is a progression. So Garisa ni dappa Garisa. This is the Purvanga.
Garisa ni dani Risa ni dappa da Sa ni dappa ma
5, 2, 5, 2, 5. The rule on the Uttaranga is that you can't have a gap after the last because you have to take the song. So in the Purvanga, the gaps can be after every element. In the Uttaranga, the gaps can be only after the first two elements. So garisa ni dappa garisa garisa ni dani desa ni dabada sani dabama gamapa mapada padani gamapada bada mapada ni dani padani sani garisa ni dappa ga. Though this can be done on stage very easy, not very difficult to do. Now I'm going to complicate this. These guys kind of took the easy way out. So they said we'll do a korvai, which has to, if I have to sing this, I have to stake it at the same point where the song begins. So saumitri, so this korvai will start. Garisa ni dappa garisa garisa ni dani pesa ni dabada sani dabama gamapa mapada padani gamapada bada mapada ni dani padani sani garisa ni dappa garisa garisa ni dani pesa ni dabada sani dabama. Now I'm going to say no. You have to start the korvai on the beat, which means it starts where the tala starts, but after three rounds you must end after two. So how will you do the arithmetic for this? Explain the arithmetic first. Sorry?
No, it has to be plus 2. Because we need 2 more. Plus so 122 is not divisible.
Now 122 is not divisible by 3. So what will you do now?
And also the length of one korvai can be any number. It doesn't have to be specifically within one cycle or one and a half.
You can have it as 4 rounds. So now 122 is not divisible by 2. So you'll add another 40 to it.
So what I would do is I would add one more cycle plus the 2. So it would be 40 into 4, which is 160, plus the 2 that we need, which is 162, which is then 54. So
every cycle has to be 54. Yeah, you sing 54 thrice, you'll come and land up at the point. Sorry? You want to go through the math, arithmetic again?
No. I think he said I'd already done it before. Right? If I heard you right. But I mean, I'll tell you how I arrived at that. There's a standard starting to a korvai, which is normally takadina tam, takadina tam, takadina tam, which is basically 7, 7, 7, 21. So I need that 3 times across 3 cycles, which is 63. And I need a total of 162. So the balance is 99. If I split that by 3, it's 33. So I need to fill up 33. That is my
math. You got it? This is the arithmetic that you do. And this arithmetic, all musicians should be able to do. You want to go, we'll go through the math again. Once more, just do it slowly. Okay. Too fast. Start with how you get to 162. First go there.
Okay, so each cycle is 40. How many ever cycles we choose from the beginning, we need 2 extra to come
get
to this
place. Get to the point of origin, right? That's understood by everybody. Good.
So, 2 cycles would be 80 plus 2 would be 82 and
that's not divisible by 3. So that's out of the question. Add another 40.
If you choose just 1 avartanam and 2, which is a total of 42, you can split that by 3, but it's too short to be able to sing a korvai. So you wouldn't normally take that. So if you take 3 cycles, the total's 120 plus 2, 122 is also not divisible. So if you add another 40, which is another cycle, the total is 162, which is then divisible. So the moment the total was 162, we have certain standard formats for different approaches and different ragams.
I'll just come to this. Now, there are certain easy arithmetic forms that you get kind of imbued. Takita, takadina tam, takadina tam, takadina tam is a set we know. Like this, you have multiple frameworks. Even a mridang is, when you just throw a new talam, these frameworks are there and they know what the count of that is. So then you start using that to then build new things. You don't start from scratch. If you start from scratch, you'll take the whole day. So you have to use these forms. So what he did is he immediately knew he had 21 in his hand.
And I multiplied that by 3.
So he said 21 into 3 times.
63.
That is 63.
And I need 162. So the balance is 99. Which I need to fill.
99 divided by 3. How much is that? 33. So every round is 21 plus 33.
Which totals to?
That's what he does.
54.
So 21 plus 33 every time is this formation now.
But again, what I'm going to do with the 33 is because the song is Saumitri, which is tam, 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 which is 3-3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the 33 over the course of 3 cycles, 27, 33 and 39.
You got that?
So the average between the 3 would still be 33.
Okay, go. Yeah, your question? Sorry. It doesn't need to be.
It doesn't have to be.
So there is one mean. There is a mean. Okay, there is not... The mean will usually be the center one. So you're allowed to... The mean will be the center. You don't have to repeat all 3 the same. There's no rule like that. So the progression makes it even more interesting, more exciting. Okay? This is a very smart korvai. Because it also reflects the line. Saumitri. So what he did is he built it in such a way. Gaddi.
Sanidani. Sa. Rit sa. Di sanidabada. Ni. Sa. Di sanidabama. Saumitri.
So the appropriateness is also there in this. Now a person who has done korvais can do this on the fly. You can actually make these korvais on the fly. I'm very bad with numbers. So for me, this doesn't work. So for me, if you give me a place, I just start singing in my head. I'll sing a form in my head, and using that form, I'll make a korvai. Usually works for me. I've stumbled a few times, but usually that works for me. But this is actually the more logical way to do it, to be very honest. That's the logical way to do it with the math. And it also has to be appropriate to the ragam. And that's a very important aspect. Now, there is this Gari Sanida is standard. You can never sing that in Shankarabharanam. Because Daivata and Shankarabharanam has very little role. Gama padani sa, ni zani gama gari zani darisa is atrocious in Shankarabharanam. Gari zani darisa ni daba, you won't sing in Shankarabharanam. In Kalyani, you'll sing gari zani darisa ni daba zani daba ma. In Kalyani, you will sing it. So, yeah.
Could you please demonstrate your way of.
Oh my God. It's years since I did korvais. Okay, but I'll show you. Now, for example, I can show you a few korvais I've done. Done a few. Idu padalam. இது மக அதான் இந்த பைரவி இந்த இதுக்கு சங்கீத சங்கீத பிரிய இருக்கா கரிசுட்டி சர்தி பதனி சனி தப்பமா பதனி கரி சனி தரி சனி தப்பமா பதனி ச கரி சனி தனி சர்தி ரிசனி தப்பதனி சனி தப்பமா பதனி கரி சனி தரி சனி தப்பமா பதனி ச கரி சனி தனி சர்தி ரிசனி padani sa sanida pama padani gari sanida ri sanida pama padani sa sangita. This is a korvai I did. Now, usually, you don't have a korvai that has two speeds in it. Okay? The reason I chose to do it this way is because sangita priya is a very slow tempo phrase. So, when I did this korvai, all I sang was this, I remember. I probably was looking for a korvai. Gari sani sari or something like that. Then I said, Gari sani dani sari is the form I got. Then I built on the form. What did I do? Gari sani dani sari. I need a board actually. It's easy with a board. But anyway. Is there a white board by any chance? Which you can quickly grab here? No, it's okay. Don't worry. It's going to be a research project. No need. If you can quickly grab a whiteboard, it's okay. Let's ditch it. No. Gari sa ni da ni sar di. Then ri sa ni da pa da ni sa. I added one to that. Sa ni da pa ma. Added two. Pa da ni. Then I flipped the kala parmana. I made it slow. Gari sa ni da ri sa ni da pa ma pa da ni sa. In the case, I've sung the same three times. Because the form itself is... it's fine like this. I can sing it differently. Gari sa ni da ni sa ri. Ri sa ni da pa da ni sa. Sa ni da pa ma pa da ni.
Gari sa ni da ri.
Ri sa ni da pa ma pa da ni sa. Gari sa ni da ni sa ri. Ri sa ni da pa da ni sa. Sa ni da pa ma pa da ni. Gari sa ni da ri. Ri sa ni da pa ma pa da ni sa. Gari sa ni da ni sa ri. Ri sa ni da pa. Padani sa sani da pa ma padani
ri sani da pa ma pa
So you can do a lot. Mm-hmm. You can complicate it even more. So it's just, that's also imagination. I mean, there are a lot of people do arithmetic progressions, geometric progressions. No, there are many korvais you can make like this. You can make simple ones also, which are very nice. Now, this korvai that sounds deceptively easy will get confusing. Deceptively easy. The math is kind of hidden in between there. There's another thing that happens with arithmetic. The way you form the swaras can confuse people. This is what happens in this korvai. Magarisa badasariga maga is confusing. Nobody understands what's actually the math in there. So you want to be a little tricky about it and you want to confuse people, you can do that also. Then the math is kind of gets hidden. So, but all this can be done on stage if you're equipped enough to do it. And if you have these forms in your head, the moment you have it, and appropriateness. There are certain ragas in which, for example, only certain forms work. Like ragas like Begada and Saveri. There's always, or Kedaragola. Yeah. You will find that only certain kinds of math will work. Certain kinds of math will not work. So these things you have to know. Again, the most important aspect in all this is raga. It's not arithmetic. You can do whatever progressions you want, okay? But if it completely deconstructs the raga, it's of no use. So when they make korvais, you know, the tough thing about making these math things on stage is that sometimes you'll get the math right, but when you sing it, it'll not work melodically. And you're just realizing and you sing it, no, this is not working, this is going, it's just going off. You just realize it doesn't work because the math works or the arithmetic works, but the form doesn't work. So which is also the reason why it's better to think of this before. Not necessarily on stage.
No, I just wanted to ask whether korvais are practiced for every rag. Do you do that or?
No, for example, ragas like Nilambari, will be most people do not sing korvais. Huh. See, a raga, korvais usually are sung in the second speed, which is not necessary, but usually. So it must be a raga that allows for, first of all, that laya. That kind of, you know, robust kind of singing. Most ragas you sing, but certain, like Manji, I will not sing a korvai. I will not sing in Nilambari. Kurinji. These ragas don't give themselves that opening to sing a korvai.
But the ragas which are allowed, you practice that separately. Yeah, in the sense, each rag separately.
No. We just practice. No. That comes just the design. The raga understanding should be imported into design by the student. So, for example, when they sometimes made korvais, in the initial days, they used to make korvais and come and sing it in class. Because, I mean, it's a very invigorating process, you know, sitting doing this math, saying, okay, this place is some five after here, how am I going to get a korvai? It can be very, you know, and we've all gone through this whole period where we'll make korvais like we are mad. I mean, every day we'll come up with a new pattern and complicate. It's a very good intellectual exercise. But then the problem happens when they actually translate and sing it. And they'll sing it in class, this just doesn't work, you can't sing it. So that has to also be learned. So we don't do korvais for ragas. But we do, that is why it's better to sing the korvai rather than calculate the korvai, which is what I like to do. One of the reasons why I just like to sing with flow and do the math, arithmetic, because I think then that naturally makes it appropriate to the ragam. Rather than do the math and then formulate it. It works for me. It doesn't work for me. Yes, for a student, the math is important. I agree. For a student, the math is important. So it's important the student comes to the teacher and sings those korvais.
Correct. It has to be understood.
When they've made a korvai, I'll say, come and sing and show it to me. Correct. I've had students who come with very complicated arithmetic ideas. So I'll say, sing it three times, we figure it out. But I'm saying, it just doesn't show. Another thing is, it's important that, like in any form, the form must be seen. The design form also must show in that raga. If that design form doesn't show, it doesn't have any role to play. So this also goes into the way we teach math or arithmetic.
I have two questions. One is taking a little bit step back to what you were talking about earlier. I just wanted to know what you exactly mean by scale ragas. And the other question was what you just referred to now, which is why Garisani Da is not allowed in Shankarabharata.
I didn't say not allowed, it's inappropriate. Because Devata, hanging on a Devata in Shankarabharam is not usually there.
But when we sing a korvai, don't you
the moment you pause in Da.
Without the pause, can we do the korvai?
Garisani Da is a Kalyani phrase. Garisani Da, Risani Da, Sani Da, Ma Da, Ma Gari. What I will do is gamma gamma bada ni zani da ba magama bada ni zari gamma gari sari magari zari gari gari zani zari zani da ba gamma bada ni za. I'll sing gari sani sa.
Okay.
Instead of da. So in Shankarabharam, I would definitely say gari zani da ri zani da ba is totally inappropriate. Whoever may have sung it. Definitely. Standing into the pause is atrocious. Gari zani da is just atrocious. Just not doable. The Devata approach in Shankarabharam is tadaranala. It's only from below. Tadarana da pa sa. There's no da position. Da is Shankarabharam da. Da is da. Gama pa na na ta la la sa da ba ma ga ma. Only when you go gama pa da pa ma ga ma. So gari sa ni da. You won't find in any kirtanam also. So that's one. And to the scale ragas, ragas evolved in two ways. For a long time, ragas evolved as organic beings in terms of tunes and melodies that were brought into forms and given forms. The theorization happened after the forms were happening. Then there was a point when people started doing jugglery with swaras. Your whole Melakarta system is a jugglery with swaras. And I have a very strong opinion on the Melakarta system, which is not a very, very complimentary opinion. It's a very good intellectual exercise, but what does it do to the idea of raga? It's something that is actually for a whole day seminar. It's not even for a conversation now. It's for a whole day seminar. And these scales basically are born out of permutations and combinations. Could be note positions, could be juggleries, could be kind of note. Fundamentally, that changes the way that raga will evolve. Foundationally, it kind of transforms the way the human intellect will engage with that being. So these scales get limited with those scales. They get trapped within that. You take any of the Simendra Madhyamams and Dharmavatis and the Shanmugapriyas, they're all scales. They all came from just the possibility that these swaras were there. There's a musicological history to this, which I'll ask you to please read, on how the Melakarta system came, why it came. There's a huge history there. So these scales, therefore, have their limitations. I am not arguing or discussing whether they're beautiful or not. That's a completely different. You may still find them very beautiful, but this is an aesthetic discussion, a serious aesthetic discussion. As an aesthetic discussion, they are stuck by scale. So because of that, when you render them, you generally land up having to jump here and there in order to keep identity in place. This never happens in a Begada, will never happen in a Kamboji, will never happen even in most of these ragas, Shankarabharam. So those ragas need to be treated differently. Or we have to try and see if we can push the rims of those ragas a bit and give them a little breather. We have to try.